ברוך השם, חנוכה is over, ברוך השם. Now we start the winter, and the winter is the time of learning Torah. Tonight there is a minhag of the Hasidim not to study Torah. I think that the real Hasidim, if you learn Torah, is good. Because to find excuse not to learn Torah is very easy. There is over here, of the Parshat Vayigash, I will start with a question, as usual. And we know that Yaakov crying for Yosef for 22 years.
Last time he wasn't crying for Yosef.
No, he was crying at home.
Oh, for the other rabbi.
Where is Yosef, Yosef Uman, this, Beit Abel Katuv. But we still have to We have to understand the pasuk Mem Vav Kaftet. He says like this: Vayeso Yosef Merkavto Vayal Lekrat Yisrael Aviv Goshna. Yaakov is coming to Egypt. He now is on the border. He's coming to Egypt. Yosef his son. He takes the Merkava. Today will be the limo, stretch limo. And he's going to welcome his father. And this it says like this: Vayera elav, vayipol al tzavarav, vayevka al tzavarav od. Meaning, and he saw him, and he was crying on his shoulder more. The Ramban, the Nachmanides, he says that Derech Eretz, when the son sees the father, what he has to do first?
Get up.
So now he sees him. Now Yaakov is sitting on the Agala, and now Yosef is coming. What should be the first thing to do?
Who's
Yosef.
Yosef?
He's coming to his father now. So he says that,
kiss his hand,
bowing down. Omer Ramban, and Rashi says that he was reading Kriyat Shema, he was not talking. Nachon?
Yeah.
Omer Ramban, I didn't understand it. It's not a kavod that Yosef at the beginning is going to kiss and hug his father. First he has to bow to him. Second he has to kiss his hand. So the Ramban is asking, how it's possible that the first thing that Yosef is doing is crying and on his father's shoulders. Therefore, the Ramban says the following. The Ramban says, "Ve'anachon be'enai that." When the father saw Yosef, the father himself was crying to Yosef. You get me? I'm sorry. ולכן הוא אומר, when When Yaakov saw from far away Yosef, the Midrash says that Yosef was given by Paro his crown. And he used his own limo of the president. So they didn't know if it was Yaakov, Yosef, or Paro. But when Yosef came closer, he saw that this is Yosef. Therefore, it says that his father fell on his neck and cried, not Yosef. And now we explained it. As the last 22 years, he's crying every day for him. ודבר ידוע, אומר הרמב"ן, it's famous, that who is crying more, the old father on the son, or the powerful son on the father? You get the question? ולכן הוא אומר, and לכן הוא אומר, according to the רמב"ן, יוסף was very successful businessman, and he had many appointments and many converse and many things. So when he saw his father, it's another list, something on the list. But for the father that was waiting for 22 years, it was a very emotional situation. Therefore, Omer Ramban, that Yaakov was crying on the shoulder of Yosef, and Yosef was saying, hello, Abba, kol beseder, so normal, but I'm busy, I have to see the You know, Yosef was a very big businessman. He moved all of Egypt from one place to other.
He didn't cry?
Huh?
He didn't cry.
According to the Ramban, he was excited. But he said the cries he left to his father. The Bukharian people say about it, they say, Dili Modar, Dili Padar, Befar Zan. Dili Farzan, Befar Sang. Which means, that the father and the mother like their children and think about the children all the time. But the children, when it comes to the father, sometimes the heart is very rocky. Sang. A piece of rock, a piece of stone. This is a very famous Bukharian guilt trips that the king, the parents said to the children. So the Ramban explains that in the meeting of Yosef and Yaakov, who was more emotional?
Yaakov.
This is the Ramban. Rashi, on our parasha, he goes to a midrash, and this midrash based on one of the Gehonim who lived in Babylon 1300 years ago. His name was Rabbi Yehudai Gaon. And Rabbi Yehudai Gaon, he has questions. And it's written over there, the question 38. We asked the rabbi why Yaakov did not pay attention to Yosef, and Yosef was crying. And not Yaakov. This is the pshat in the pasuk. Omar Lahem, the Gaon told them, he was busy reading Kriyat Shema, and he could not make any efsek. Now he's reading Kriyat Shema, he's busy to say Shema Yisrael, Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem Echad, Ve'ahavta v'chulei.
The famous question would be, if it's time for Kriyat Shema, for Yisrael, what is
it? Oh, so Aaron asked the question, the Maharal is asking this, but we'll come to him slowly, slowly. Let's go. Let's visit with the first question that we have. You know, when was the first time we say Kriyat Shema in the history? Who remembers? Yaakov Avinu, before he dies, 1 hour before he dies, he wants to tell to his children about the future. What the children are telling, they suddenly understand that. He cannot say nothing, כתוב שנסתרה ממנו. He was afraid, one of the children maybe is not ראוי, is not appropriate, there is a problem. He look at them and they say, and they told him, Shema Israel, listen our father Israel. Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem is our God, Hashem Echad. And God is one. And what Yaakov said? Baruch Shem Kvod Malchuto L'Olam Vayed, Chudo B'Shkur. And then he died after a few minutes. My question to you, this happened 1 hour before he dies. This what I'm telling you now is something that happened 17 years before. So which Kriyat Shema Yaakov was reading? So we spoke once and we explained to you that Shema Yisrael is more a concept thing. That you feel, זה נקרא בעברית, זה נקרא ייחוד. מה זה ייחוד? אז ריבונו של עולם, God, I love you. God, you are the only one. Thank you for everything. It doesn't have to be the text of Shema Yisrael, it has to be the concept of Shema Yisrael. The meaning. כן, like everybody prayed according, so זה נקרא ייחוד קריאת שמה. This I understand. But let's come to the second question. And I was looking in the Gemara where I found to find it, and it's very interesting. There is a in Gemara Masechet Yoma, Daf Yutet says the follow: if somebody is reading Kriyat Shema, he should not make any kind of signs in his eyes or in his lips. Or in his you cannot say, "Ve'avta et Hashem Elokecha b'chol levavcha, b'chol nafshecha, b'chol me'udecha." Ve'ayu ha'dvarim ha'el Hashem tzavecha hayom. If you say like this, it doesn't call Yichud Hashem. You're just reading something, but you really don't mean it. אז אומרת הגמרא, ואמר רבי יצחק בר שמואל בר מרתא הקורא את שמע לא ירמוז בעיניו ולא יקרוץ בשפתותיו ולא יראה באצבעותיו. ותניא רבי אלעזר אומר, הקורא את שמע ומרמז בעיניו ומקרץ בשפתותיו. The Ketuv say on him, "Velo oti karata Yaakov." There is a certain, there is a prophecy in the Nevi'im that they say that this is not the way to say Kriyat Shema. You really not say Kriyat Shema. You're just saying something and you don't mean it. I saw over here the Maharsha on this. He says the follow. He says, "Velo oti karata Yaakov var bekama mekomot." Yaakov Avinu had two names. One name was Israel, and one was Yaakov. Israel means the letter of head, Rosh. Yaakov means the matter of Ekev, heels. Sheshem Israel al Shem HaMa'ala v'Hashivut, v'Shem Yaakov al Shem HaAkev v'Hashiflut. V'lachen b'Kiryat Shema, we have to say Shema Israel. You have to be the most concentrated in the word Israel because your head should be with the Kadosh Baruch Hu. V'im kara kedino, aval im lo kore kedino, ze nikra kmo Yaakov. It's not Shema Yisrael, it's Shema Yaakov. It went to the lower level. He's really not focusing over here. V'shamati al ze ha-midrash omer ha-marsha, sheba Yaakov le-Misraim, it said that Yaakov was crying on his shoulder, and Yaakov did not cry because he was reading Kriyat Shema. And when you read Kriyat Shema, you have to be you and Hashem. Seder? Very good. This what the Maharsha says in regarding to this. The Maharal, Maharal Miprag, he has a book by the name Gur Arye. And he asked a different question that Aaron asked it, and I'm very happy because I feel it is the right direction to show. He says, wait a minute. If it's the time to say Kriyat Shema, if it applies to Yaakov, it applies to Yosef and the brothers, nachon? So why there is not over there a break that Yosef says, wait a minute, everyone's going to say Kriyat Shema, all the Jewish people over there. And after 5 minutes, speak to your father. If it applies to Yaakov, why doesn't it apply to Yosef? The question is, the second question he asked the Maharal, maybe Yaakov was praying Tfilat Shmona Esre. The same halachot, Tfilat Shmona Esre, you close your eyes and you pray. How do you know it was Kriyat Shema? This is the two question that the Maharal is question. Yes.
Krishma, you could sit in the wagon while they're driving. They could say Shema Yisrael. With Amida, I don't think he is allowed to say.
So you say he was sitting, But old people, when they sit there, they pray too. You say standing. Omer kacha maharal, simu lev. Because when Yaakov came to Egypt, and suddenly he see that from the limo of the king, coming Yosef HaTzadik, look, dressing like a king, have a crown like a king, but look like a Jew. Yaakov start to increase his love to Hashem. And he says, how HaKadosh Baruch Hu running his world in a perfect way. And now all the prophecies and all the promises and all the dreams and all the thoughts and all the prayers and all the hopes and expectations, everything become now fulfilled, valid. The reality, this is the reality apparently. איך מידותיו של הקדוש ברוך הוא עם טובות ושלמות ומשלם שכר טוב לרעיו. And all the questions, why Hashem, and why this, and why, all the whys are going now. וזהו מידת החסידים עושה המהר"ל, say the מהר"ל. This is the good quality of the real righteous people. That if something good happened to them, they become closer to Hashem. And they want to להידבק, they want to attach themselves to הקדוש ברוך הוא. על הטובות והאמת שעשה. And this is קריאת שמה, when you say, שמה ישראל, השם אלוקינו, השם אחד, you are the only one, one, the only one, אחד, יחיד ומיוחד, and ואהבת, and I'm going to love השם. וכאשר רבה יוסף אחר הצער הגדול שעלו בעבור הורא אותו מלך, היה אוהב את הקדוש ברוך הוא. עכשיו, what about יוסף הצדיק, why he's not doing it? So, הלכה דרך ההלכה, יוסף is doing כיבוד אב ואם. So, he's פטור from the מצווה. נכון? דרך ההלכה, you have two מצוות to do. Now you see your father, say hello to him. So Yosef, because he was on Kibud Avayim level, Kiryat Shema can go to the second level now. This is the...
He doesn't mention about the other brothers and everybody else.
They were playing
Kiryat
Shema. Huh? Well, Izzat. Is it Padar? Is it Padar? עכשיו, חידושי הערים, he brings it, his שפת אמת brings all kind of חידושים from his parents, and he talks about a Hasidic understanding of this מהר"ל מפראג, and I'm going to read it for you. He says the following. This Divrei Torah we're giving on 1887, about 130 years ago. Noda kvar, it's found that we know the Divrei de Maharal in the book of Gur Aryeh, why Yaakov did not kiss Yosef, because he was reading and dealing with Kriyat Shema. And he explained that when a tzaddik comes a certain pleasure, ahava v'simcha, he added it to avodat Hashem, to make himself through this to become closer to Hashem. V'lachen, therefore, he read over there Kriyat Shema, because he wanted through this to even become closer to Hashem. ועל פי הפשוט טעם הדבר, כי הרי לנפשו שעל ידי זה אהבה, ישכח אהבת הבורא, לכן הוא מדבק מקודם בו, שישכח ממנו אהבת הגשמיות. וזה נאמר בכל לבבך. He says the following. Let's say somebody likes food. And there is a mitzvah, Roman, there is a mitzvah to eat good food on Shabbat. So when he eat the good food on Shabbat, is he really concentrate that the purpose of the eating is to become close to Hashem? Or is telling to himself, אבל יש כמה מסר כונה, באת וקל והשם. That is he using the food of Shabbat for his own pleasure, or he looks at it as a part of his mission. So he says that usually when it's come to this world, it's very easy to make this mistake. You get me, Roman? I will explain. There is a mitzvah to you after you got married, Roman. There is a mitzvah to you to go to work, to make money, and bring to your wife to pay the bills. There is a mitzvah. Okay? Now, let's say this coming Monday is a legal holiday. And let's say I'm going to make a shiur in the morning. And you will tell to yourself, you know what? Instead of coming to the rabbi shiur, I'm going to make another delivery. Why? Because I start to like the idea of going to work. Why? Because I make more money. Then I can buy a better car or whatever. All this, whatever this olam hazeh has to offer. So he really doesn't go to work because he wants to make Hashem happy or his wife happy. He wants to make himself happy. Then, when he starts to lose connection to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. You get it? But he's going to work. He says, whoa, what? I'm not doing any sin. You get me? Or let's say there is a, I tell you something in the level, you're going to understand even better. A lot of the husbands, they complain about it. That whenever I need my wife, she calls to her mother. She's by her mother's house. So whenever I need her, she's her mother. So you call to your wife, she say, I have to go there, I have to help my mother, this. You say, no, you have to be over here. But she's using this. So it's really the question, does she love her mother or does she love her husband? It's become a whole issue. What I try to say that the Sfat Emet says that then Ikram, you have to love HaKadosh Baruch Hu b'chol levavcha b'yeser tov b'yeser hara when there is something that is very close to the yeser hara. Like food, like money, like power, like all kind of desires. If you make it for mitzvah, it has to be for HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Am I clear? I'll emphasize it here. It is coming Thursday, we're going to have a fast, nachon? We're going to fast, L'Shem Shamayim. Nobody likes to fast. We have to have the same feeling when we eat, L'Shem Shamayim too. Not L'Shem Ishkam, L'Shem Shamayim. But when you are in a pleasure thing, it's very difficult to differentiate. So Yaakov was in such a level, he says, that when he saw Yosef, he said, let me take the love of my son and bring it to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Say, Ribono Shel Olam, thank you for this. Thank you. Yichud. Hashem, I love you more. It's not first. It's the idea is that I want to share this minute with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. I will explain. When my grandmother, she came to Israel, 80 years ago. And all the brother and sister left in Samarkand. And whenever she had the grandson, or she had the wedding of the daughters, or the children, so she used to tell us, Chursandimam bekigoyam. You understand? I want to share my happiness with my relatives, but they are not here. It's not that it's coming instead of the love. I want to share I want to share it. So in this kind of happy time, Yaakov says, I want to share my feeling now to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Because usually, in this point, people are going far away from religion. Korash Butchu. So, there was another pshat over here that the Sfat Emet says over here. And he says that why Yaakov, Yosef kissing Yaakov, and Yaakov is standing like this. He says, Sfat Emet, he says like this. And my father used to say that Yaakov became an angel already. And Yosef now is in this world. He's young, he's in the business, he's in the work, he's this. So Yaakov, when Yosef see Yaakov, he wants to come closer to his father. But Yaakov is already, for him, it doesn't mean anything already. It's just a matter of, okay, so it's a love, but he said the direction is from Yosef to Yaakov, which is another pshat. I don't want to, I want to go to a different direction with your permission. From this coming Thursday is going to have a fast, the fast of Asara Betevet, nachon? The Gemara in Masechet Ta'anit and in Shulchan Aruch they bring it, there are four Ta'aniot that the prophet says that from there we learn that we have to fast, because if there is no prophecy, we're not allowed to fast. The only fast in the year is Yom Kippur. So the Navi says Soma Revi'i, Soma Chamishi, צום השביעי וצום העשירי יהפכו לבני ישראל לשימי שמחה וכולי. The fourth month fast, the fifth month fast, the seventh month fast, and the tenth month fast are going to turn to Am Israel to happy days. Which is the fourth? Nisan, Iyar, Sivan, Tammuz. When we fast on 17 of Tammuz. What is the fifth? Av, the ninth of Av. What is the seventh one? Tishrei, נכון? Gimel Betishrei, Tzom Gdalia. And the tenth one is Tevet, Asara Betevet. Now, it goes, by the time, it goes different than the real thing that happened. And the real first event that belongs to the Churban was the tenth of Tevet, נכון? What happened in the tenth of Tevet? They started the siege, the blockade around Yerushalayim, in time of Nebuchadnezzar. After three years, or the 17 of Tammuz, or in Tammuz, they were broken inside the city. On Tisha B'Av, they destroyed Lo Aleinu Beit HaMikdash. And on Tishrei, after the Jews start to fight with each other, Gedaliah ben Achikam and Ishmael ben Yonatan, then they killed him, so then they exiled everybody. So by the real sequence of days was the fast was Tevet, Tammuz, Av, and Tishrei. But the Navi says by the time 4, 7, 9, 8, and 4, 5, 7, and 10, it comes the last.
Tishrei means
Gdalia. Gdalia, yes, Siyumi Tishrei. By the way, the right way to say Tashri, like the Bukharian. This is the real name. Tishrei is a Israeli changing.
Tashri.
Now, what is the halakha? I want to ask you a question. What happens if Tisha B'Av happens on Shabbat?
We push it off
to
Sunday.
What happens if 17 B'Tammuz happens on Shabbat? Pushed it. Now, and Tzom Gdalia, about Asara Betevet, there is a rabbi by the name Revi David Abu Darham. He lived about 700 years ago in Spain, and he wrote in his book of Halachot, and the Beit Yosef bring it, Besiman Taf Kuf Nun, he says that according to him, if עשרה בטבת fall on Shabbat, you have to fast on Shabbat. Like Yom Kippur. And they ask him, why, according to you, Rabbi Abu Darham, we have to fast on Shabbat? And he brings the prophecy from the book of Yechezkel. Yechezkel says for the follow. Vayi dvar Hashem elai, this is Yechezkel 24. בשנה התשיעית בחודש העשירי, בעשור החודש, in the 10th month and the 10th day, he say, בן אדם, אמן, כתוב לך את שם היום, את עצם היום הזה, when king of Babylon made the siege on Yerushalayim. אומר, עצם היום הזה. אומר, אבו דרהם, there is one place in the world, he talks about fast in the word עצם. When is this? כיו היום הזה, כיו עצם היום הזה. So he says, basically, he says, according to this, because it says be'etzem, if it happened that Asara v'tevet happens on Shabbat, by the calendar it doesn't happen. If it happened on Shabbat, we are going to fast on Shabbat, which is a big chidush. And my question to you, and I want to make all the question now one big question of why Yaakov doesn't kiss Yosef, and why suddenly Asara v'tevet becomes such, if it's a Shabbat, you have to fast on Shabbat. Where can we find the connection to this? And I believe the answer is very simple and very painful. You know what, from all the fasts, I told you what the fast was. What was the fast? The siege, breaking of the wall, burning Beit HaMikdash, and killing of Ishmael, of Gedaliah. Which of them we talk about a date that really nothing happened there? Nachon? What happened there? Nothing. A siege around Jerusalem, nachon? Nothing. Nobody touched inside people. In this day particular, people went to war, came home, you know, Bseder, Chai, there is a siege, Chai, Paganaz, Mishode. Huh? מחשבה, גזירה. What is the problem over here? And I don't know the name. I had a meeting a few years ago with an old American Jew, very nice person, and he told me a story. He told me that in 1935 he left to Berlin to meet with the Jewish community of Germany. And he offered them to give them visas to come to America because Germany is become very dangerous. He told me that they were laughing at him. And they were willing to pay to American Jews, each of them $5,000 as donation to give them a gift. Say, don't worry about us, worry about yourself. We're talking about over here the why we have to fast on Shabbat according to the Abu Darham, because this is the time that you really can do something. When it's destroyed, you cannot do nothing. Yes. We sometimes like to deal with the problem when they are on already. It's much better to deal with them when you see it, when you feel it the first time. And I'm going to answer about Yaakov's behavior when he meets Yosef, and then I go to what I want to discuss with you tonight. When Yaakov is coming to Egypt, imagine, he's coming with 70 people. He's sitting, and he sees the delegation that come to welcome him. What he sees over there? The limousines of the government. He sees Yosef coming like a king. He sees the houses over there. He sees what they are preparing over here, and he's telling to himself, my family is going to start now a very long and difficult galut in Egypt. It won't be galut of hardship. It will be galut of a lot of money, power. The uncle is the king. Access to all the money that you want. The best education, the best yeshivot, the best houses, the best temples. And Yaakov is very worried. As I told you today in the afternoon, it was much easier to be observant Jew in Chitirchi than in Tashkent. Because when you're not exposed to all this power, you can work on yourself, because Judaism is based on, it's a very strict system of laws. But when you expose to the culture and you have power, most of the Jewish people cannot cooperate with this, cannot cope with this. Yaakov Avinu is looking at Yosef and he say, my son Yosef is a special person. But Mitzrayim will not be the house of Yosef from today on. It's going to be Reuven, Shimon, Levi, Yehuda, and the children, and the grandchildren. And Yocheved, that was born 2 hours before he came inside the Mitzrayim. She, Yocheved, grew up already inside the Galut. And Yehuda went and prepared to his father a huge place and a nice Beit Midrash, and they had a lot of success over there. And Yaakov is telling to himself, how many Yosefs I have in my family that will be able to carry it on? The fact was, as we know, that 80% of the Jews in Egypt could not leave Egypt. And from all the Jews who left Egypt, few of them came to Israel eventually. Dor HaMidbar was dying in the desert. So Yaakov basically